Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. So, at the World Cup, we are waiting for the tiebreak of round 2. Some top GMs won their matches, while others must play the always exciting but risky tiebreak. So, watching the tournament 3, that I will also put in the description below the video, we noticed that Ding, Grischuk, Svidler, Anish Giri and many others today must play at least 2 rapid games. On the contrary, Karjakin, Nepomniachtchi, Mamedyarov also that I show you the game, Maxim Vachelagrav and Wesley So, among also others, were able to win their matches. In our video, we will watch together Wesley So's game against Anton Demchenko, Russian grandmaster with a rating of 2655. So this is a game quite different from the fireworks that we watch in other games, but I'm sure that you will enjoy it and that it will make us think. So let's get started. Wesley So with the white pieces opens with d4, Demchenko answers with d5, c4, e6, knight to c3, this is the queen's gambit declined, but here comes a6. This is an interesting sideline, so what's the idea? I didn't know, so I opened the database and I went to watch some games from these great players. I found that also Carlsen used this move. Especially interesting is his game against Nikolic, grandmaster with the rating of 2600, that Carlsen won in 22 moves. So, going back to the idea is that black will capture here on c4 and if white will be able to recapture with the bishop on c4, black will play b5, will develop the bishop in fianchetto without this d5 pawn, so a beautiful square for the bishop, and this is a setup that can give white some problems. So let's go back to our game. After a6, Wesley So continues with the best move, doesn't allow this idea, he continues with c captures on d5. So here comes e captures on d5, knight to f3 and knight to f6, bishop to g5 pinning this knight, now bishop to e6 and e3 of course to free the way for the bishop. Knight in b goes to d7, so this knight is protecting, is also with the queen protecting this knight on f6, bishop to d3 the best square for the bishop, here comes c6 and queen to b3, attacking b7, this is a novelty, because before h3 or short castle were played. Both short castle, h3 and also queen to b3 are all good moves, so this is a novelty, the game is completely original. Here comes queen to b6, and Wesley So, you know that he is not scared to change the queens. Queen captures, knight captures, and now this is an interesting moment of the game. So, without the queens on the board, the game becomes, of course, more strategic. So, is it a good idea now to change this dark square bishop that also seems the worst bishop, because the central pawns are on the same color? So, is it a good idea to change this bishop on f6, giving away the bishop pair but ruining the pawn structure? Wesley So and Stockfish, they think that this is a good idea. So, here comes bishop captures on f6, the g-pawn recaptures, and here comes knight to h4 controlling f5, because of course, if possible, black will like to advance this pawn. Here comes a5, now both short castle and long castle are possible, but let's learn from Wesley So. Here comes long castle, because in this position, with the king on the queen side, he wants to control black's advancement and he wants to win the game here on the king side, where he has the better structure. So here comes bishop to b4, knight to e2, and here comes knight to c4, knight to f4, not targeting this light square bishop for two reasons, because this is the bad bishop, watch the pawns. And if now or later white will capture, it's true that black will lose the bishop pair, but it's not important now in this position. The important thing is that black will improve again his pawn structure. So knight to f4, not to capture here the bishop, but to play knight to h5, targeting this weak pawn. So here comes bishop to d6, but the knight will jump to h5, so bishop back to e7, protecting this pawn. Knight to f5, now this knight is now targeting the good bishop. So, good idea by black to exchange on the knight. Bishop captures, and knight to d6, now targeting the bishop. The bishop moves back to this perfect square, d3. Here comes rook to g8, targeting g1, rook in h goes to g1, and f5. Knight to g3, attacking the pawn with the help of the bishop. And here comes bishop to h4, that is pinning this knight. So the second rook moves to f1, bishop captures on g3, and of course it's the h-pawn that we recapture. Let's watch a bit this position. White is better. And funny enough is that Wesley So gave away the bishop pair in his first moves, and now he's the only one with the bishop on the board and with the pawns on both sides. So this is a good advantage. Also, the pawn structure is better, and black need to connect the rooks. So here comes h6 first, because this pawn was under attack, so was indirectly attacked by the bishop. Here comes rook to h1, controlling the file and attacking h6. So rook to g6, much better, much more active than rook to h8. Here comes rook to h5, now two pieces are attacking again this pawn. And because rook to g6 is more active, then from g6 the rook can move to f6, adding a second protection. But the structure is so bad that this h6 pawn goes under attack again. Rook in f goes to h1, doubling the rooks on the h5, impossible to defend this pawn, so at least black continues with king to e7, giving the back rank to the second rook. Rook captures, and rook recaptures. White is a pawn up, also controlling the only open file. So what to do with this rook? Demchenko plays the best move, rook to g8, that brings the rook to the semi-open file. True that this open file seems blocked, but there is no file better than this for the black rook now. So here comes king to d2. This is another maneuver that we must remember, because to win the game, white needs the help of the king. So Wesley So starts to move this king into the action. King to d7, king to e2, king to e7, never a good sign when you go back and forth. King to f3, and the king is on the right side of the board. b6, king to f4, rook to g4 we check, king to e5, and what to do now? This is another important moment of the game. Best line of play for black is to play rook to g6, threatening this rook. Of course, white will never change here, improving the structure, but will move the rook to the back rank to attack from behind. Now, probably the best move for black, the best try, is knight to e4, attacking f2, and if this pawn advances, the other pawn will fall. So this is the best try, but white is dominating the position. But let's explore well this line. Let's understand why Demchenko didn't play like this. So, because for white it's not possible to defend f2, he continues with rook to b8, attacking b6, b5, rook to b7 we check, and king to f8. b3 now, an important move that stops this black advancement here on the queen side. The knight captures on f2, and moving away from this diagonal, here comes bishop captures with tempo against the rook. Rook captures on g3, also e3 is under fire, so king to f6, and white doesn't care about this pawn, because it's better to improve the king. Now, if black doesn't capture here on e3, this rook to b8 is checkmate. So, of course, rook captures on e3 will come, so that if white plays rook to b8, we check, the rook can interfere and shield the king. So what to do now? Rook captures on f7, we check. King to e8 or king to g8, more or less is the same. Let's explore just one line. Let's try king to g8. So rook to g7, we check. King back to f8 and rook back to c7, attacking this pawn. Now, in this position, it's +3 for white, because one of the problems for black is that with the king so much active, black can't change the pieces. Let's watch what happens if knight to e4 we check. It happens that bishop captures, rook captures. White will force black also to change the rooks, rook captures, king captures, and the king will move and will destroy the queen side, winning the game. It's already game over, because let's remember that if now c5, not d captures on c5, or this pawn will advance and it's impossible to stop. So if c5, king captures, 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 and again white arrives first and will destroy this queen side. Also, there is this passed pawn on the other side of the board. So let's go back to rook to c7. So what to do? Not possible to change the pieces, so better to play rook back to e8, but this pawn now is lost. Rook captures on c6, knight to e4 we check, and king to g6. So white has a completely winning position, even with the best play from black. So that's why Demchenko doesn't play like this, going back to king to e5. He doesn't play with rook to g6, but he tries a trap. Let's go back. After king to e5, here comes f6, we check. Only possible move, because the king can't move, is to capture with the rook on f6. And here comes knight to f7, we check. This is the trap. Now, if king captures on f5, white lose the game, because here comes rook to g5, we check, supported by the knight. The king must move away from the rook. The black king will capture the rook, and black will win the game. So, going back to our game, after knight to f7, we check, Wesley So, of course, doesn't fall into the trap, and plays rook captures. On f7, we check, king captures. Bishop captures on f5 with tempo, rook to g7, and here comes g4. This is a strong move that makes strong all the position here on the king side. Black continues with king to e7, at least preventing the white king to d6, but here comes f4. Rook to g8, g5. Watch these connected pass pawns, also supported by the bishop and the king. Rook to e8 with the threat of a discovered check, but before the king can move away and give the discovered check, here comes bishop to e6. The king can't move away, we check, and in this position, black resigns. So let's just play some other moves, a possible continuation. So the king is useless here, so must move. King to f8, king to f6, unpinning the bishop, rook to e7, at least controlling this 7th rank, and here comes g6. Now, if rook to g7, that is a sensible move stopping the pawn, here comes bishop to f7, creating this important structure. Here comes c5. D capture, B captures, and bishop captures on d5. Rook to c7 is one of the best moves, but here the other pawns will start to advance. e4, c4, e5, c3, and white can even don't care about this pawn, because here comes Bishop to f7, blocking the rook so that now the pawn can advance with check. This is the move and the setup that we must remember. Here, there is nothing to do. Rook to c6 with check is blocked by e6. C captures on b2, but there is no time to promote to queen because g7 is checkmate. And with this checkmate position, we can also end our video. I hope that you enjoyed the game, of course, and that you will keep watching the World Cup with me. See you soon with a new game. Goodbye!